a sawmill in Flanders was a bad motherfucker. He was 17 feet tall, he had 150 wives. He didn't do that much except he saved a game of baseball. He put two and two together and he noticed it was four. Now the treachery of Shoeless Joe can't hurt us anymore. And he'll always be remembered as Kennesaw Mountain Landis. Fella named Joe Jackson was a fielder for the Black Sox. And he always wore his black socks, but he never wore no shoes. He weren't the nicest fella, and he had a couple problems. Cause he drank a lot and he beat his wife and he always acted rude. He killed and ate some babies and he copped an attitude. One man they hated most was Kennesaw Mountain Landis. Mafia said, Shoeless Joe, you should really run this show. You should be the guy who owns baseball. All you really gotta do is help us make a buck or two. We'll bet on the other team. You lose the game but make it seem like nothing further from the truth. Shoeless Joe did what they say, dropped a couple fly balls, and he walked up to the pitcher and he poked him in the eye. In the seventh inning, with the Black Sox nearly beaten, there was someone who was watching from his blimp above the stands, cradling a rifle in his thick and meaty hands. As if you hadn't guessed yet, it was Kennesaw Mountain Landis. Kennesaw said, drop that glove, or I swear by God above, I'll make you regret playing baseball. Shoeless Joe looked up and saw silver rifles gaping maw. Though no one had noticed yet, his underwear was getting wet. He beat himself in front of everyone. Shoeless Joe's finished, but he couldn't quite admit it, so he raised his middle finger up above the other four. Kennesaw took careful aim and fired a single bullet, and he shot that dirty finger off and dropped his trusty gun. And everybody in the stands knew he had won. And today they still refer to him as Kennesaw Mountain Landis. Shoeless Joe left baseball and became a famous pop star. And he asked the musical question, is she really going out with him? He had a couple albums and a comeback in the 80s, but he never won a Grammy and he never was the same. And he never could be satisfied with critical acclaim, but the critics all confused.